The Queen will be very annoyed. Her Majesty is only person who can tell Prince Philip, 97, this is enough, you've got to stop driving. The Queen is the only person who can tell Prince Philip to stop driving following his miraculous escape from a road crash. Ingrid Seward, editor of Majesty magazine, said the Queen would be telling her 97-year-old husband this is enough following yesterday's horror collision. The royal was at the wheel of his Land Rover Freelander when it collided with a Kia car as he pulled out onto a busy road near the Sandringham estate in Norfolk. The smash flipped his two-ton 4x4 over onto its side, splintering the windscreen, after telling police officers that he had been dazzled by the sun at a T-junction. Remarkably, he was said to be uninjured after the incident. However, royal watchers now say he will face calls from family members to give up driving as a result. M. Seward, who claims to know several royals personally following a 20-year career covering the household, said Her Majesty will be very annoyed with her husband. She told Good Morning Britain, "I suspect his children and grandchildren will chime in and say, 'Look, come on, Pa, this is enough. We just don't want to lose you like this.' But it will be the Queen. She'll be the only person that can really tell him. And I'm sure she'll be very annoyed with him this morning. Obviously sympathetic, but she will be saying, 'Now, Philip, this is enough, you've got to stop driving.'" Why weren't royal protection officers in the car? Palace faces questions over why Prince Philip was on his own at time of crash, as Princess Diana's ex-bodyguard claims Duke would often take off without security. Prince Philip was driving alone with no bodyguard on board when he crashed, and the 97-year-old royal is prone to driving off without security to keep his independence, Mail Online can reveal today. The Duke of Edinburgh's collision near Sandringham yesterday raises major security concerns and is a breach of protocol, experts have said. Roy Warren, 75, the man who pulled the Queen's husband out of his written-off Land Rover, has revealed there was no royal protection officer in the car with Prince Philip when he crashed with a Kia. "It is understood the security team followed in a car behind and arrived very quickly, but only once Philip had been dragged to safety from his written-off Land Rover. But outside the gates of their private estates, the royal family should always have a bodyguard next to them," Princess Diana's former security chief Ken Wharf has said. Mr. Wharf, who served in the Met for 35 years, told Mail Online Prince Philip has a reputation for giving his police protection officers the runaround and has been known to tell them, "I don't need you, leave me alone." He said, "The yard has questions to answer because officers need to be able to stand up to him. I'm convinced that if a PPO was in the Land Rover with him, the crash wouldn't have happened." He added, "The Queen may drive alone on the estate from time to time, but she would never leave the gates without an officer with her in the car and back up behind. She would be absolutely livid, firstly through concern for her husband, and second that there have been two people injured with a baby on board and it could have been much worse." Mr. Wharf, a former SAS-trained officer who Prince William and Prince Henry affectionately called Uncle Ken, protected their mother, the Princess of Wales, from 1987 to 1993. He told Mail Online today, "The Duke of Edinburgh is known to be very difficult when it comes to personal protection officers, PPO, especially in a holiday environment like Sandringham. I know he would say things like, 'I don't need you, leave me alone, I'm fine on my own,' and could take off without them. I suspect he has decided to drive to see a friend off the estate and just left. The security team will have been forced to jump in a car, followed, and then be completely horrified as they came across the crash. 99 times out of 100 nothing would happen if he went on his own, but when it does go wrong, it's often a complete disaster, as proved here." Mr. Wharf said previously senior royals each had their own personal protection units, but this has been changed to a rota system where officers are allocated to different members of the royal family. He said, "In the past you would have officers with decades of experience who would know how to deal with the Duke and convince him they should be with him when he drives. That's all gone."